Episode 92, Tools for Authentic Marketing. Welcome to Be Who You Want to Be, Your Business, Your Life, the podcast for micropreneurs designing your business and your life on your own terms. I'm your host, Kandas Rodarte, and today I'm joined by DIY marketing nerd, Carol Clegg. Carol helps small businesses share authentic content on social media. She loves teaching solutions on how to master your own marketing until you can afford to pay a team to help you. Welcome, Carol.
Hi, hello, and thank you. Thanks for having me on the show. And I'm just looking forward to this.
You're a nerd, I'm a geek. We're going to have a lot of fun. So why don't you start off by telling us your unique story? How did you get to where you are?
So I would say about a decade ago, we moved to New Mexico from Charleston, South Carolina, although you could hear by the accent that I'm South African, originally from Cape Town. But I've almost been gone from my home country as long as I lived there, which is kind of crazy. I'm like getting to the cusp of that. But we moved here and I just love sharing other people's stories. I love pushing things out, and social media was coming alive sort of, you know, whatever it was 10 years ago. And I decided I was going to become a VA. So I taught myself how to be a virtual assistant and all the tools that I needed, and just have always loved marketing. So that's kind of where I started and went through all the ups and downs of, you know, learning how to run a business, what tools I needed, what would make my life easy, working with different clients, and then kind of deciding, there's some people I don't want to work with, and there's some people that I love working with. And so I've narrowed that side of that business down. I work with three clients now, and one of them I have been working with since I started, and the other one from 2015. And then the other one is a new company that's just established, a air charter company in the Caribbean. So that I've decided to kind of put the lid on that. And that's my one side. It feeds my passion for marketing and I can service those clients. And then I'm always learning along the way. But from that came the thought of, hold on a minute, I can hold the hand of other women who want to walk the same journey. And so from that, it birthed into a mastermind, helping other people, the podcast, and yep, we go from there. So I never stop learning. I think that's what keeps me young.
I think that's part of marketing, is that you never stop learning. You should always be learning new things because it doesn't change. I'm sorry. It doesn't stay the same. Marketing constantly has to change because the methods to deliver your message are constantly changing.
Absolutely. And you kind of need to be in the know. I mean, I don't need to be in the complete know of absolutely everything because we can't know everything. And I don't even think we want to teach somebody else everything. So that's kind of where I come into that authentic bit is, hey, let's step back from this. Let's work with people that really resonate with our heart. And that's who we can help, because otherwise they're just going to go, she's not for me. What does she know?
Well, and your message, if you're marketing correctly, you have a very small niche, and your message to that niche doesn't have to be on every single marketing channel, just on the channels that your clients hang out on.
Absolutely.
Okay. So I want to talk about organization, because one of the biggest issues that most micropreneurs have is they don't know how to organize anything. So Right. Obviously you have some systems in place. So talk to me about your systems.
I do. So I, you know, which one to start with, but I guess I'll start with my Trello board. I absolutely love my Trello board, and I have Trello boards where I work with my clients and they're on those boards. So we can talk to each other there, and it keeps the conversation in one place, because I think when we communicate across too many different platforms, be it WhatsApp, email, text message, it just gets lost. So my Trello boards help me. I also have made one for my week. And within that, I have my top three items. So I use that and I keep that open. I've got two screens. My other saving grace is my Google Calendar. Everything goes on my Google Calendar. And then what I've stepped into recently that I'm finding super helpful is the night before, I go to the task bar and I select three tasks, and I task one and I give it a name, and they would be the pressing things that I know that I need to get done tomorrow. Probably the things I don't really necessarily want to do, but if I get them off my plate and I don't have a huge long to-do list, then let's just knock those three out. So I put those on my calendar the night before. I give them a time slot. And then when I open up my calendar in the morning, I look at those and I know what I've got to do. The other thing I do, as much as I love my Google Calendar and my Gmail, is I only check email maximum three times a day. Because if it's open all the time, I am so distracted. I sign up for a lot of newsletters because I think that's part of the learning curve, that you're always, you know, wanting to hear from others, learning from others. And so that distraction helps me to close down my email box.
I use Google Tasks a lot too, but I don't do it the same way you do.
Okay,
I have repeating tasks. So I have my non-negotiables, yes, that I have to do every day.
Right.
And those tasks show up at the time that they need to show up on my calendar. You know, I get a little pop-up. It's time for you to
do such and such.
Yeah. And they're non-negotiables, the things I have to do every day. And again, three is a magic number. And I only have three of those.
Yes.
I only have three of those. Okay. So talk to me about Trello, because Trello doesn't work for me.
And that's interesting because I used to use Asana, and because a client wanted me to be on Asana. So I tried that out and we worked it out. But I guess Trello works for me because it's like a whiteboard.
Well, you might want to explain what Trello is for someone who's never used it.
Absolutely. So think of it as a whiteboard and think of it as a visual. And you open up a board, which you would give a name, and then you would have cards, which create these linear cards, if you'd like, on the Trello board. And then within that, you would have different tasks. The beauty of, you can add people to the board. So if you are working with somebody, you could add them and your communication flows. You have the ability to put due dates onto tasks. You can switch from Trello and move it across to a calendar view if that was important and you needed to look at it that way. You can link to documents on Google, Dropbox, whatever you want, if you needed quick and easy reference. But I just use it in so many applications. I use it even as a storage space. So if you are a business owner and you want to remember your links to all your websites, your social media, because you've got to share them with somebody, I keep them all on a card. So I can go in straight away and pull that link and put it in to my newsletter. Tell somebody's asking me, you know, I think you had asked me in our chat, you know, what are my different social media profiles? I can just pull the links as opposed to having to open up LinkedIn, copy and paste. I've got them all in one place. So it's a fabulous storage system.
I think maybe I was using it wrong when I tried to use it before.
Oh, you and I'll have to get on a Trello.
A Trello training. You know, so I do a lunch and learn I'm just going to book you now for it. So I do a lunch and learn every month, and the rest of the year is already booked out. And so is January of 2022. But would you like to come on the lunch and learn in February of 22 to teach how to use Trello?
I would love to do that.
All right. First Monday in February, 2022. Carol Clegg is teaching Trello.
Okay. I have that down. My goodness, 2022. It's
that far away.
I know.
September.
Yeah,
it's 6 months away. Yeah. You know, that's February.
I came across this phase the other day about, is September the new January? And I was like, woo. I don't know about you. Do you like setting New Year's goals? I don't.
I don't really set, set goals, so to speak. I set action steps. A goal is a dream, right? It's just something out there. Oh, I want to travel the world. Well, that's great. You want to travel the world, but that's when are you going to do it? How are you going to get there? How are you going to pay for it? And all that stuff. So you got to have action steps. So I'm all about action steps. So at the beginning of the year, I might set some action steps, but like I said, my lunch and learns for the rest of the year are already scheduled, right? And already planned. So I have long reach with the way that I organize things.
And there are some things that we need to put on our calendar, you know, far ahead. I've stepped into claiming May 2022 for my Lisbon retreats. I have canceled that, I think it's 5 times now.
Oh, yes. Well, let's just jump into this Lisbon retreats thing. Talk to me. This is one of the reasons why I wanted to interview you.
That, oh, thank you.
Portugal. Oh my gosh. Tell me about your Lisbon retreats. What are those all about?
So this got birthed when I was on a trip with a bunch of women. There were about 15 of us, and we were on a working trip together. We didn't know each other. We all met in Lisbon. We had co-working space booked. We shared apartments, and I had this amazing experience. And I just went, I have to recreate this and create it again for other people. And the blessing, I suppose, in having to reschedule it so many times is I have tweaked it and tweaked it and tweaked it. And what I thought was the perfect in the beginning, which was 2018, has now come down to something completely different. And what I'm now doing is I've realized, just because I love working on my business and I love spaces, as I mentioned, being an older location independent business owner, doesn't mean everybody else does. And doesn't mean everybody else is as willing to travel independently as I am. And so I've been thinking about that and, you know, mulling over it. And I've now changed it into a three legs. So what it's going to consist of now is the first 3 days, which would start on a Friday, of just being in Lisbon and enjoying, settling in and enjoying being a tourist. And I'd have everything arranged. Follow that with 3 days in a co-working space with masterminds, coaching, hot seats, et cetera, so that you're not overwhelmed and it's not all business. And then finishing it off with, it's Thursday night through to Sunday at what they call a quinta, which is, it's a yoga retreat. And it happens to be owned by a South African woman. So I'm just so excited. We've been communicating for years. And she's got this gorgeous place about 30 minutes outside Lisbon. And we will wrap up with the last 4 days with just self-care. So that's my dream for 2022.
So it's a 5-day event.
It's 10 days.
10 days. And how many days of that are business masterminding?
Three.
Wow. So those hot seats are, and how many women are you going to have?
10.
Wow. Are you going to hot seat every day or just...
Yes.
One at a time.
We'll have to.
So every business owner will have an opportunity to be in the hot seat at least 3 times.
Absolutely. Yeah.
So for those of you who don't understand what we're talking about with this hot seat, masterminds, okay, don't think about those Facebook groups that have 20,000 people in them. That's not a mastermind. What a mastermind is, it's a small group of curated people who have different goals and different skill sets who come together. It's usually facilitated by a facilitator like Carol, right? And the hot seat is when the person speaking has an opportunity to share what their frustrations are or to brainstorm ideas. And then the other participants in the mastermind give feedback and ideas. And it is one of the most powerful things that you can do for your business or for any part of your life. So I'm a huge fan of masterminds. And brilliant. So brilliant.
Thank you.
Do you have all 10 seats filled, or if someone wants to be involved?
No, if somebody still wants to be involved, that's really easy. My website is lisbonretreats.com and everything is on there. So,
If you want to spend 10 days in Portugal working on your business and yourself, lisbonretreats.com. Oh, amazing. I love it. All right. So obviously travel is an important part of your life. So how do you juggle the travel and working with your clients?
So one of the things I have done is I like to try and complete my heavy duty internet needed work ahead of time, because I have found that if you're relying just on your phone or you're going somewhere where there might not be a co-working space or, you know, you don't have a good connection. So I do try and batch that as much as I can when I know how long I'm going to be away for and get that taken care of ahead of time. I also, once again, use my Trello board and plan that out with my clients. So we put some due dates on that so that I know what I need to block out when I'm traveling and when I've got to say, if I'm traveling with my husband or my daughter, you know, I know what I've got to do, when I've got to do it, and I can set time aside for that. The importance of letting your clients know that you're away and perhaps on a different time zone. Because if you don't, and they're wondering why you haven't responded. I batch some time ahead of traveling. I use my Trello board, and then I set some time aside when I'm away to work on work.
Excellent. Again, that was three things.
Yes.
The magic of the magic of the number three. Communication, I think, is the most important thing. You've got to communicate. I can't remember the last time I actually worked in an office. I've worked from home since 98, I think. So that means you can do anything you want. But for those of us who have just learned this magic of working from home thing, it's kind of hard to learn how to juggle. So being organized, having a plan in place, and communicating, those are really three really important things. Okay, let's talk about my favorite subject. And I really want to pick your brain about, well, you know what? Before we talk about marketing tools, let's talk about LinkedIn. Because a lot of people think that Facebook is where it's at and it's the only thing, but that's not where business happens. Facebook isn't where business happens. So you really need to figure out how to take your message to LinkedIn. And Carol has done that. So talk to me about your LinkedIn group and how it works and how you collaborate with it and all that good stuff. And why LinkedIn? Why you believe LinkedIn is where it's at?
So I find LinkedIn being helpful for me to communicate. You know, I want to work with women, midlife women. And so my audience is coaches, women stepping into their own businesses. And I think the fact that your bio can say so much on LinkedIn, it gives you an opportunity when you first look at somebody, you don't need to dig in. You can. So that's why I say to people that is so important to have it in those first handful of lines. And then one can be, you know, LinkedIn has changed so much over the years. I mean, before it was for recruitment agencies and you had to have the pro account and, you know, that's all it was. Your resume was out there. Now there's a different, it's professional, I feel. And you see so much more than in a Facebook group. I have a very small Facebook group and it's really just for the people in my mastermind because I want to encourage them and educate them and share. But it's not a group that I want to grow to, you know, 5,000 people. You don't know the people behind those pictures. But on LinkedIn, you can see the quality of what people post and you just get to see a little bit behind the scenes. But I have a different approach and some people might not agree with this. I have heard many people speak differently. But when I reach out to connect with people, I don't send a note. I occasionally might, like, you know, if you and I, because we're doing the podcast together and perhaps, you know, just if your inbox is full to remind you where we met. But for the most part, I don't. And to me, it's up to you to look at what I do. And am I somebody that you want to have in your circle that you might want to collaborate with? Because many people don't bother to look at what people do. And they just invite people and backwards and forwards. Well, there's no point on that. I mean, I have sifted through my LinkedIn connections and moved a lot of people out because we're not going to do business together. And if you come and sell at me out of the gates,
I agree with you on that because there's nothing more annoying to me than when somebody makes a connection request on LinkedIn and it's accompanied by 8 paragraphs talking about how great they are.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
What was the point?
Right.
You know, right. What, why are you spamming me with your made Absolutely. Up BS, right? Your made up
mm-hmm.
stuff.
Mm-hmm. No, I agree with you. But I started the LinkedIn group and it's a long process. So I'm not suggesting that it's easy. It's not nearly as easy as starting a Facebook group and you don't have the same interaction because LinkedIn hasn't got it together yet. And I know that they will in time. I mean, they keep changing things. I believe they're dropping stories now.
Oh, okay, that's hot off the presses. That was announced this morning. And today, I wanted to talk to you about that.
Yeah.
So that I have a theory about that because I just don't, because YouTube added the shorts, those 60-second video shorts, and which is basically what stories is on Facebook. And it's the same thing on those things that go away. I just don't think that has legs.
I don't think so either. You know, I think that's Instagram's field. Leave it on Instagram. You know, the Twitter is trying to start with the chats. And, you know, I try and I go in there with the, I don't know what they call them. You know, and Marilyn Scar, she does a very good job on Twitter, but it just isn't working for me. So I'll stick with Clubhouse for the audio.
Stay in your lane.
Yeah, LinkedIn, you know, the stories didn't make sense on LinkedIn. I mean, people don't go there for too much behind the scenes, behind the scenes, behind the scenes. Mm-mm. So just to share on my LinkedIn group, you know, how I try is I send people an invitation. I do tell them that it's an opportunity for them to promote themselves, because it absolutely is. You'll see some groups on LinkedIn where the owner of the group, that's all they do is talk about what they have, their products, their services, and that's all you get. I occasionally will come up with a little something about what I do, maybe, you know, to my detriment, maybe I need to shout a little louder. But I just like to highlight other people. I like to share what they do. And so I do things like a post where I'll say, okay, who in my group is in the copywriting industry? Pop a comment down below. Let us know what you do. Let us know who you serve. The unfortunate thing is you can't tag those posts like you can in a Facebook group. So I have to repeat it. In other words,
you can't hashtag them?
I could hashtag them. I don't know how that would serve in a group. So I need to look into that. And LinkedIn just definitely needs to improve the way groups operate. So I do, when I post with my own feed, I look for something that's of value that perhaps one of my connections shares, and they're in the group. I'll take it over and I'll repost it in the group. And then once a week, I will recommend, because you're allowed to do that once a week, you can recommend a post. I tend to do that for the members of the group, because then it broadcasts to everybody who's in the group. And my group's not big. It's about 250 people at the moment, but I like to think of small and quality. And if we can get to know each other, and if you're looking for a copywriter or a VA or a business coach or a life coach, we're all women and we can support each other and do business with each other.
So that's all about micro-influence. And that is the new thing. Micro-influence is where it's going, which means that you have a small group of people that you have influence over. Right. And that small group of people thinks that you are the one. And the difference between that and, you know, being an influencer like the Kardashians is that, you know, I don't think that the Kardashians are an authority on anything. I think they're just really good at promoting themselves.
Right.
But you, because you have run this group with, and you have these 250 people who know, like, and trust you, you are an authority to them. And they, you know, they have confidence in you and they support you. Whereas, you know, honestly, the Kardashians are just a joke, in my opinion.
That, yeah. No, that's, and it brings us back to the authentic. Is
exactly.
I want to know the people that I'm talking to and work as best I can. I can't remember everybody. But you know, and then what happens is you cross paths again on another platform. So I have found that there've been people that I have met on Twitter. I have made some valuable connections on Twitter. And then we've crossed over and I've seen some people on Clubhouse. So I value that cross connection. I guess it just reinstates, you know, if you're meant to walk the path with somebody, whether it be in collaboration or as a client. And it takes forever. So that's one of the things I want to say to people is don't give up. Building your community takes time. It really does.
It does if you're doing it correctly. I mean, you can build a community. I mean, there are a whole bunch of people who say, oh, I can help you create your Instagram followers to 5,000 people in 30 days.
Right.
Well, are those really followers that you want to have following you, or are they just people's names? The other thing I like about LinkedIn is that it's really hard to be a fake person on LinkedIn.
Absolutely.
There are fake profiles on LinkedIn, just like anywhere else. But it's not like Instagram or Facebook where I'm constantly getting slammed by these handsome military generals, you know, that are just about to retire and they're extremely good looking and they have a beautiful family and this great looking dog. Constantly.
So tired of those. So tired of those.
There are so many of those generals who want to be my friend. That doesn't really happen on LinkedIn. So it is a more authentic conversation.
No, I agree with you. Yeah.
And it's to me, it seems like a better place to reconnect with people that you used to work with. And, right. You know, you may not work there anymore, but just because you don't work there anymore, or even in that industry anymore, doesn't mean there might not be a connection.
Absolutely.
So I have a connection on LinkedIn, somebody I worked with 25 years ago, and I recently was able to connect him with someone who lives here locally who needed what he does.
I love that.
25 years, I haven't seen this guy.
Yeah.
And I was able to connect him with someone and he doesn't even do what he did then. He does something about
it. Oh, interesting. But I love, there's just such joy in connecting others, that there's a benefit that comes out of that, you know, you just store these things. And then, as you say, you were able to to bring two people together.
Yeah. So LinkedIn, it really is about linking. And yep. So LinkedIn is great. Okay. So we've talked about Trello. We've talked about LinkedIn. I would love to hear the rest of your tools. share with me all your tools for authentic marketing.
So mine are really simple. I need to bring in a third one because I only have two. I'm sure I can find a third one. But what makes my life simple is Buffer and Canva. And what I am super excited about is the integration now with Canva on Buffer. And I use Planly for Instagram. So there, I noticed I said I'm all P's. P for the podcast, P.
You know what? I actually use Canva to post to Instagram. I just post directly to Instagram in Canva. Yeah. And then I use Buffer. So Buffer is my favorite scheduling because it's the simplest.
It's gorgeous. There's just so much that they've kept adding to it. So I have my clients in Buffer and I have my own accounts in Buffer. And I can schedule. I can, you know, you can repost, which is awesome, especially when it's somebody, you know, for instance, the airline, they're selling charter. It's the same thing. I can pull up a post from a month ago and we can, you know, reuse that. So that also comes down to, you know, if you're going to spend a day on your marketing, pull up your Buffer, pull up your Canva, shut out to the world, spend a day and you're done for the month. I mean, it's just so freeing. But this new integration with Canva allows you to go into your folders and it automatically resizes. So you know how if you make your images in Canva and you download them to your computer, they are what they are. But now with this integration, you go into your folder. So I use it for Pinterest and it stretches my image and I can make the text bigger to be better for Pinterest and it pulls it into Buffer and off we go.
Okay, you just told me something I didn't know because I do resize all of my, I make my graphics in Instagram. So yeah. I make my 10 by 80 graphic. And then what I do is I resize it into Pinterest, Facebook, and Twitter, right?
Been there, done that.
Because LinkedIn and Facebook, you can use the same image.
Right.
But Twitter is this long thing.
Exactly.
And, you know, wide, and Pinterest is long. You know, so you start with your square and then you just, so I've just been doing that manually, but now you're telling me that you can go to Buffer and Buffer will do it for you.
Yep. So when you go to schedule your post, it'll tell you where you're bringing your image from and it'll give you the choice and it'll say computer or Canva. And you just click on Canva and it takes you over to your Canva account. And then you go into your folders where you've stored whatever you might be working on promoting, etc. And whoops, pull out that image and it resizes it for you.
So do you have the paid version of Canva or
I
the?
Do,
okay.
I do.
That is the best $13 a month I spend.
Yep.
Canva is so much more powerful. I know how to use Photoshop. I used to do all that stuff in Photoshop, but it's so cumbersome and it takes up so much space on your computer. And it really, it's this huge mega program and Canva does everything in it. I have hundreds, maybe even over 1,000 images stored on the Canva cloud.
Absolutely. And then your branding, you know, you can pick your colors, you can store your fonts. Mm-hmm. It just keeps getting better. So
my favorite feature of the paid Canva is when I find a graphic that I like and I want to use it as a template, I just go into
folder
where you click one button and it changes the color of the graphic to your colors.
To your brand. Yes.
Brand colors. Yeah. What is that called?
I don't know. It's funny. You know, often
It might be called branding.
I think it could be. Often I just do things and I never know what they're actually called. But that brings me back to my love of learning is I will find a way to do something.
So your tools are Buffer and Canva, and you don't have a third, but it is Trello. Trello is your third tool.
I guess Trello is my third.
Well, and that you also mentioned Planly. So talk to me about Planly or Planoly.
Planoly. So Planoly. Yep. Mustn't forget the O. I just use that for Instagram. And that's probably partially because of my love-hate relationship with Facebook. I know that it can, I can go into Facebook and I can schedule it there. And I do that for my clients so that we, you know, doing everything at the same time. But I try to stay off Facebook if I can.
And yeah,
that's just personal. So I like to be able to load up my images, put in my copy and schedule it out. ahead of time. One of the things I heard the other day, and I don't know if you've heard this, but somebody recommended it: when you use a scheduling tool for your social media, it is a good idea to go on either ahead of your post and or afterwards and do some engagement. And part of that apparently is to support the fact that you've automated your post, but by showing up in person and commenting and liking and engaging, which is why we do social media, that will help balance up using auto tools. I don't know if you've heard the same thing.
It's very true. If you are not engaging, I have a new video camera. For those of you who are watching the video and I keep going in and out, I have a new video camera. It's supposed to be like the greatest, I guess a really expensive video camera too, or a webcam. It keeps making my face blurry. So sorry about that if you're watching the video. Why is Kandas blurry? If you're not watching, go watch the video. Okay. Anyway, where was I going with the story? Yeah. Engagement is really important, which is why a lot of people hang out in one place, because they don't want to engage in multiple places. The algorithms are smart. They know if you're just auto posting. Right. So if you want your place to be Instagram, you need to go and hang out on Instagram. You can auto post, but you need to hang out on Instagram for a little bit every day. And I mean every day. If you want to engage. Other than that, you're just going to see the same people posting over and over again. And those are the last five people that you engaged with, right? So if you don't want to see the same five people and over and over again, you've got to go and engage with more than those five people, right? Okay, so Planoly is just Instagram?
It does Pinterest as well.
Okay.
And I have a free account on that one. So you don't have to have a paid account.
Okay. And so Buffer does post to Instagram.
It does it all. Now I have Buffer that posts to my LinkedIn group. Not my group, sorry. It'll post to my LinkedIn business page, my personal page, Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. I don't know if I've left anything out.
Those are the important ones. Snapchat. And, we're both a little too old for Snapchat. If I got a Snapchat, my daughter would kill me.
That's what I said to my daughter about TikTok. I said, what would you do if you saw your mother hooked on TikTok? And she says, I'd kill you.
Okay, so explain to me the reasoning why because it's a DIY marketing thing.
Absolutely.
Why would you use two different scheduling softwares?
So it is part of the reason Buffer only allows me 10 accounts. And so I have my clients on there and my own. Okay. And so it's just to simplify. And I just like to keep Instagram out of the mix and separate. So it's just a personal preference. But if you know, I have a paid account, but I've been with Buffer forever. I know they've upped the amount, but I'm one of their, I pay $10 a month. It's now 15. And I think it's 8 accounts and I have 10. But it's one thing that I'll never let go of. But that is it. I've maxed out my accounts. And so I need a different platform.
With Planoly, does it let you post to Instagram and then Instagram auto post to Facebook?
I probably, because I'm not using that feature.
Okay.
I can't answer you on that one.
Okay. I want to give people tools.
Absolutely.
And tools are super important. Super, super important. Yes. You taught yourself how to produce and host a podcast.
I did.
Tell me that story.
So once again, going back to my VA days, I had a client who was a physical therapist out of New York, and she does a podcast. She still does. And so I had to learn really quickly how to produce her podcast for her, and she used Libsyn. And so we pulled it together, and I helped her for about 2 years producing her podcast. So I had a little bit of background knowledge on, editing and what to do and how to pull that together. But then what happened I'm almost a year old with the podcast. About a year ago, two of my mastermind participants who've actually become really good friends, we decided, well, hold on a minute, coffee chat. Let's just have a coffee chat live on Facebook. I was using StreamYard then, so we would go to the Facebook group, their Facebook groups, because I could pull that all in, LinkedIn and my page. And we were just going to spend 10, 15 minutes, because one of the girls is a life coach, the other one's a yoga teacher, and then myself as a business coach. Different markets, different avenues. And we thought, well, just chat. It's, you know, just chat and share, just like you and I are chatting now, just organic. So we started doing that for a while. And then I thought, well, hold on a minute. Why am I not taking out the audio and creating a podcast? So I did need to get their commitment that they were going to show up with me. And so we played around with, you know, well, how often are we going to show up? And sadly, we have now gone from the three of us to just the two of us that have continued. But in October, we'll be a year. And yep, I have, you know, here we'll come to the platforms and the tools that makes podcasting easy for me. And I don't know what you're using, Kandas, but Buzzsprout is where I host. I use Podpage because it's given me, I bought the domain name for Connect, Inspire, Create and host that on Podpage. And they make that super easy. People can send you emails. They can, so that's just in conjunction with Buzzsprout. And then Podmatch, where you and I met. I'm enjoying what he's doing there. And then StreamYard and Zoom. So I guess those would be my podcasting tools.
So you are still streaming, using StreamYard to stream to Facebook?
No, I'm using Zoom now.
Zoom. Okay.
Yeah. So if I do something with StreamYard, generally it's me popping in ahead of time to say that the podcast is coming up or to do something. So StreamYard has kind of fallen off the podcast tools for me, but it certainly is like you're doing now with doing a live, you know, recording to YouTube. I mean, I know you want to do editing.
No. I don't stream live.
Yeah.
I want control over what I put out there and produce. So the video replay will be unedited and that will go up on YouTube and it'll go live the same at the same time as the podcast, but the podcast is highly edited.
Right. Yeah. What tool do you use for?
Okay. So for my podcast, it's hosted on Libsyn. I've been using Libsyn since 2015. There is no better podcast host, in my opinion. I have never had an issue with them and it is so cost effective. I've never had an issue. So I'm a huge fan of Libsyn. And then I actually use my website, my WordPress website as my RSS feed.
Right.
So I use Blueberry to create the RSS feed from my WordPress site.
Okay.
So I don't have to have my podcast hosted separately. It's hosted by Libsyn. The episodes
and they send it out. Yes.
The Libsyn hosts the episodes. Blueberry creates the RSS feed, but my website is where the RSS feed comes from.
Right.
Okay. Yeah. So and then I edit my podcast on Audacity, which is a free free sound editor, and it's amazing. It works perfectly. And if I do video editing, it's Wondershare Filmora.
I was just gonna say use Wondershare to do my podcasts.
Yeah.
I just use it for the whole batch.
You edit your audio on Filmora.
Yes.
And so that is brilliant. Because my number one issue with Audacity is that I cannot control the level of the sound as well as I want to. And Filmora is it's a lot easier to control your sound level. Mm-hmm. So you know what? I may edit this podcast using Filmora and see what happens.
There you go. Because the beauty is you just download, you know, the MP3 from Zoom, pop that in, drag in your music and your intro. And now they've got all sorts of fancy tools to help you adjust the audio and, mm-hmm. you know, bring it in and fade out. And they're great. So.
Well, I actually record on two tracks. So my Zoom will be on two tracks because I want to control the sound. I want your volume and my volume to be the same.
Right.
It's difficult.
It is.
But you can do that on Audacity, but Filmora is actually a little bit easier to use. So
it is, yeah.
I might try that.
There you go. And for the listeners, you see, look how many tools we're throwing out there for do it yourself.
We have come up with so many tools. Okay, we started with Trello. We went on to LinkedIn. We talked about Buffer, Planoly.
Canva.
We've talked about Canva and then a whole bunch of podcasting tools. I don't remember them all, but there will be a list of all the tools that we have discussed in the show notes. It's momgeek.com/92. So all the tools that we've talked about today will be listed with links. Wow. We've talked about so much. It's time. We need to wrap. I wish we didn't have to, but we need to wrap up. So you've accomplished so much. You've got this thing going on in Lisbon, but what else? What else do you have planned? What is your next big fat hairy goal?
So I think that trying to create digital courses is on my list. Perhaps that'll be September to January to 2022, but just creating some of what I am making to help others, turning that into a digital course. So I'm using Podia, another P. So that'll be my next kind of goal, but I do want to make sure that I'm focusing on what I'm doing and try to do that well and keeping the fun in this all, because that is why entrepreneurs, solopreneurs, whatever, the element of fun has got to be there. But a hairy goal is on the personal side, a dream. And that would be to spend my year with my husband between three different places. And that would be here in New Mexico, Portugal, and you know why, I love Portugal, and then Bonaire in the Caribbean. And that's a whole nother story. We raised our children on a sailboat in the Caribbean, so it's also dear to my heart. But if I could now in my 60s live in three different places, that's my dream.
Thanks for joining us this week on Be Who You Want to Be, Your Business, Your Life, episode 92. Check the show notes at momgeek.com/92 for links to all the resources mentioned today, and of course, to connect with Carol Clegg. Be sure to follow us on iTunes, Stitcher, Amazon, and Audible, or wherever you listen to podcasts, so you never miss an episode. This is kind of exciting for me because I am now streaming live on Audible and Amazon Music. So if you're tuning in from those, welcome to the show. Listen up, you and I both know that you are dazzling and you are spectacular and you possess magical gifts that no one else in the world possesses. That is why I created Micro Influencer Magic. It's just for you. Book your discovery call with me to learn how Micro Influencer Magic will help you cast your spell. Look for the link in the show notes, momgeek.com/92. Our theme music is Never Give Up, written and performed by Soul Lily. I've been your host, Kandas Rodarte, and yes, you can be who you want to be. Take it away, Soul Lily.
Feel your spirit, let it soar. Fly away and be free. Take less, always give a little more now. Be what you want to be. Oh, never give up on dreams. Never give up on dreams. Never give up, never give up. Never give up on dreams.